Hello there, welcome you all in the Fresh Arena by Nitesh sir. Students, today in this video lecture we will discuss about the new topic, that is a change of a state. Children, already in the previous lecture we have learned what do you mean by matter and what may be the different phases of a matter. Okay children, so already again I am going to give a glance that what do you mean by matter. Matter means anything which occupies space and have certain mass and also can be perceived by our sensing organ, that substance is said to be the matter. And also the matter is subcategorized into the three parts, as solid, liquid as well as gas. So how the change of the state takes place and what do you mean by the change of the state of the matter. So from here what we can define, that the change of state of matter is a phenomena in which an object changes its state, from one to another state by the absorption or rejection of heat by keeping temperature as constant. So children, what do you mean by the change of state of an object? So with the help of this statement we can define that the change of the state of a matter is a phenomena in which an object or matter changes its state from one to the another state by either absorption or rejection of the heat energy by keeping the temperature as constant. In other words, how we can define the change of a state? So in other words we can define that the change of a state is a phenomena. It is a phenomena in which an object changes its state by keeping physical conditions such as temperature constant. So children, what I have written here, I have written that a phenomena in which an object changes its state from one state to the another state by keeping its physical conditions as a constant means what should be constant, temperature of that material should be constant, then it is said to be the change of state of that atom. So as we are knowing that there are the three states of a matters are there as solid, liquid and children gases. So it might be possible that solid changes its state from solid to liquid and liquid changes to guess. So there are the different phenomena due to the change of the state which may causes. So students, what do you mean by melting? So the first phenomena I am going to give with a glance, that is melting. What do you mean by melting? So melting is a process of change of state of an object which is in solid in state to the liquid. So students, what do you mean by the melting? Melting is a process. It is a process in which it is a process in which means melting is a process in which a solid changes its state into liquid by the absorption of heat and keeping temperature as constant. So children, if a question may arise that what do you mean by the melting, okay children, then we can define that melting is a process of change of a state of a solid to the liquid by the absorption of the heat energy and keeping the temperature as constant. So children, we can also see that if we are having an ice cube and if we supply some amount of heat energy to the ice cube, then after certain duration of time that solid material, that is ice cube, gets converted into the liquid. So this change of state is called as the melting. Okay children, so melting is a process in which a solid changes in its state to the liquid state by the absorption of the heat energy by keeping the temperature as constant. That phenomenon is said to be the melting. Okay children, now what do you mean by the freezing? Similarly, we can state that freezing is a phenomena in which it is a phenomena in which a liquid gets cooled or freezes at a particular temperature freezes at a particular temperature into solid. So children, what does it mean? It means that a phenomena in which the liquid gets cooled or freezes at a particular temperature and gets converted into the solid, that phenomena is said to be the freezing. For example, we can also observe that when water gets cooled or freezes, then it converts its state into the ice cube in the form of ice cube, which is a solid state. Okay children, so vice versa, that melting and freezing both are the vice versa phenomenon, whereas in the melting solid changes into liquid, whereas in freezing liquid changes into the solid. Okay children, now we are turning towards the vaporization and evaporation processes. Now children, we are proceeding towards the next phenomena that is known as a boiling or vaporization. What do you mean by the boiling or vaporization? So vaporization is defined as a phenomena in which a liquid gets converted into water vapor. It means that liquid changes into vapor state, then it is called boiling or vaporization. Okay, children. So in order to define the phenomena of boiling or vaporization, what we can give as a definition, we can say that boiling or vaporization is a phenomena in which a liquid changes its state to the water vapor, that is a gaseous state, then it is said to be the boiling or vaporization. Okay, children. And for the different, the thing which we have to note that the boiling point or boiling temperature may vary for different fluid. Okay, children. It might be possible that for the liquid, in case of liquid, the boiling point of the liquid may varies due to the dependency of the type of the object we have chosen. So now, children, we have learned what do you mean by the vaporization, what do you mean by the boiling, what do you mean by melting, and what do you mean by the freezing. Now the next term which we have to know, that is the condensation. What do you mean by the condensation phenomena? Okay, children. So already we have learned that the melting is a process in which the solid changes its state from solid to liquid, whereas in freezing, liquid changes from liquid to the solid, and vaporization, here the liquid changes its state to the vapor state. And now we are going to learn about the condensation phenomena. So a phenomena in which water vapor means gaseous state, water vapor changes its state into liquid state. What I have written here, children? A phenomena in which the water vapor, means water vapor in the gaseous state, changes its state into the liquid state is called condensation. Okay, children. So how we can see these phenomena, children? With the help of the various examples, we can see all these phenomena. Here I am going to give you the elaboration with the help of certain example. So children, in case of melting, what we have observed? We can observe that if we are holding an ice cube, if we are holding an ice cube and if its temperature gets increases, then the ice cube, which is in a state of solid state, gets converted into the water. That is, it means that is in liquid. And if a substance changes its state from solid to liquid, then it is said to be the, then this phenomenon is said to be the, that what? That is a melting phenomena. Whereas in case of freezing, so children, in case of freezing, let us suppose that if we are having some amount of matter, and if we cooled it or freeze it, then the water converts into the ice cube. Water means that is a liquid state, and ice cube means that is a solid state. It means that in this condition, the matter part converts from liquid to solid, and this phenomenon is said to be the freezing. Children, now we are turning toward the boiling, or that is also known as a vaporization. Okay, children. So what do you mean by the boiling or vaporization? A phenomena in which a liquid gets converted into the water vapor. Okay, children, liquid means that is a water. Let us suppose that if we are having some water and if we start to give some amount of heat energy externally, then the water vapor will be converted into the water will be converted into its vapor. So it is from the liquid state to the gaseous state, and this phenomenon is said to be the boiling or vaporization. Whereas in case of what? That is a condensation. In case of condensation, water vapor gets converted into the liquid. It means that from the gaseous state to the liquid state. So this phenomenon is said to be the condensation. Children, so today with the help of this video lecture, we have learned that what are the various, what do you mean by the change of a state? Change of a state is a phenomena in which a matter part changes the state from one to the another state. That is known as that phenomena is said to be the change of a state. Whereas we have learned that melting, freezing, vaporization, which is also known as boiling, and also the phenomena of condensation and their differences. So hopefully you all have got all the points which have been elaborated by me. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day.